In this video, we will discuss about what is hashing, next day about hash table, next day about hash function, what is hash function, and what are the different types of hash functions that we have, and what are the characteristics of a hash function. So we will discuss all these topics in this video. First, let's see what is hashing. Hashing is mainly useful in order to overcome the problem with linear search and binary search. We know that the worst case time complexity of linear search is order of n. So we know what is linear search. Compare key element with elements of the array one by one until key element is found or the array is completed. Let us assume that the key element is found at the last position. Then how many comparisons will be needed? N comparisons will be needed. So we can say that the worst case time complexity of linear search is big O of n. Likewise, the worst case time complexity of the binary search is order of log n. So in linear search and binary search, we require more number of comparisons for performing the searching operation. Here we are using hashing in order to perform searching operation in a constant computing time. That means with the help of only one comparison, that is nothing but big O of 1, order of 1. With the help of only one comparison, we can perform the hashing. So what is a hashing? Hashing is a technique in which we can perform searching operation in a constant computing time. That is nothing but big O of 1. With the help of only one comparison, we can perform the searching operation. So why hashing technique was developed? In order to overcome the problems with linear search and binary search. Linear search requires big O of n comparisons. In worst case, linear search requires, binary search requires big O of log n comparisons. Okay, so to some extent we can reduce the number of comparisons, but binary search also requires more number of comparisons, whereas the technique called hashing requires only one comparison for searching operation. So that is about what is hashing. Now let's see what is a hash table. Hash table is a data structure. Here hash table is nothing but an array. Hash table is an array which contains a fixed cells, which contains a fixed cells where each cell contains a pair called key and value. So what is a hash table? Hash table is a data structure called an array which contains a fixed cells. Here each cell contains a pair called key and value. So let us assume that these are some keys and these are some values, 22, 33, 44, these are nothing but some values, okay. Here key is nothing but the index value, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are nothing but index values, whereas value is nothing but the record which we are inserting into the hash table, okay. So by using hash table, we can store some records, okay. Here the size of the hash table ranges from 0 to size minus 1, because for implementing the hashing we are using arrays. We know the index of an array will start from 0 and continue up to n minus 1, where n represents the size of the hash table. Here the size represents size of the hash table, okay. So by using hash table we can store some information. And the next one is hash function. Hash function is mainly useful in order to store the records in the hash table. So we can store records or some keys in the hash table with the help of the hash function. There are three types of hash functions are available. The first one is division method. The second one is mid-square method. So let us write now. So types of hash functions. Types of hash functions. Hash functions are classified into four types. Hash functions are classified into four types. First one is division method. Division method. Second one is mid-square method. Second one is mid-square method. Third one is digit folding method. Digit folding method. Or this method is also called as pairing method. Digit folding method or pairing method. Or pairing method. And the fourth approach is multiplicative hash function, multiplicative method. So there are four types of hash functions are available. Okay, first one is division hash function, second one is mid square hash function, that is nothing but mid square method. Third one is digit folding method or pairing method. Fourth one is multiplicative method. First let's see the division method. Here division method is the most commonly used method for implementing the hash function. So we know the advantage of hash function. By using hash function, we can insert records into the hash table. Let us assume that here we have some records like this: 33, 11, 66 and 44. Here the formula here is H means hash, H of key is equal to key modulo size. Here size represents size of the hash table. So let us assume that this is our hash table. Let the size here is 10, so we can have totally 10 cells from 0 to 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so we can have how many cells? 10 cells from 0 to 9, where each cell contains a key and a value. So H of key is equal to key modulo size. Okay, so what is key here? 33. So 33 modulo size, what is the size of the hash table? 10. So 33 modulo 10 is nothing but 3. Okay, so here division method is mainly implemented by performing the modulo operation. So here the formula is H of key is equal to key modulo size. So 33 modulo means 10 means 3. So now 33 will be inserted in the star index. Okay, likewise H of 11 is equal to, what is the key here? 11. 11 modulo 10. So 11 modulo 10 means 1. So 11 will be inserted in 1 index. Okay, 1 index. Next, H of 66 is equal to key modulo size. So 66 modulo 10 means 6. So 66 will be inserted in 6th index. Okay, next 44 will be inserted in 4th index. Next 10 will be inserted in 0th index. So likewise division method will be done. Okay, so what is the formula here? H of key is equal to key modulo size. So division method means by performing the modulo operation, we have to insert the corresponding record into the hash table. Okay, these are nothing but the index values. Okay, we can call 10, 11, 33, 44, 66 as records, or we can also call these as some keys. Okay, whereas these are nothing but some index values. Okay, now let's see the second method. So what is the second method? Mid square method. So let's see what is a mid square method. In mid square method, we have to perform square operation and calculate the middle part. So the middle part will become the hash key now. Okay, so let us assume that here we have some records like this: 22, 11, 13, 14. So these are the records here. So H of key is equal to, here the formula is key square. First we have to perform key square. So H of 22 is equal to, so what is 22 square? So 22 into 22, 22s are 44, 484. So what is the middle value here? 8 is the middle value. Okay, so 22 should be inserted in index 8. So let us assume that this is the hash table. This is the hash table. So let the size of the hash table is 10. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So what is mid square method? We have to perform square operation on the corresponding record and calculate the middle value. That middle value will become the index for storing that record. So H of 22 is equal to, if we perform the square of 22, then the result is 484. In 484, what is the middle number? 8. So 484 should be inserted in 8th index. Okay, next let us do the next one. H of 11, 11 square is equal to 121. So in 121, what is the middle number? 2. So 121 should be inserted in index 2. Next, H of 13 is equal to, 13 square is equal to 169. So what is 169? In 169, what is the middle part? 6 is the middle part. So let us insert that 13 in let us insert 13 in 169. Next, what is 14? 14 square means 14, 14s are 56, 14 ones are 14, 14 into 5, 196. So, h of 14 is equal to, so 14 square is nothing but 196. In 196, what is the middle number? 9 is the middle number. So, 14 should be inserted in 9th index. Okay. So, this is nothing but mid square method. Okay. Let us do the next one. So, what is the next one? Digit folding method or pairing method. So, which can also be called as digit folding hash function. Digit folding means we have to divide the given key or the given record into various parts, and by performing some simple arithmetic operations, we will get the corresponding index. Let the records are like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the first record, 5, 6, this is the first record, whereas 1, 3, 2, 5, this is the seventh record, whereas let us assume that our hash table size is 200. So we can store records from 0 to 199. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is digit folding method? We have to divide the given record into several parts. Let us divide this one into three parts, and by performing some simple arithmetic operations, we will get the key value. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 56. Let us perform some addition operation. So 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 2, 12. So 1 plus 5, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, 102. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 should be inserted at the index 102. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now let's see the next one, 1, 3, 2, 5. So let us divide this one into some three parts, where the first part contains 1, whereas the second part contains 2, third part contains 25. So 1, 3, 25. So if we add these three parts, then what is the output? 29. So 1, 3, 2, 5 should be inserted in 29 index. So this is about digit folding method. Okay. Now let's see the last one. What is the other name for digit folding method? Pairing method. Okay. Now let's see the last one, multiplicative method. Now let's see the last type of hash function, that is multiplicative method or multiplicative hash function. Here we, in order to find out the key value, we use a formula called h of key is equal to floor of table size into key into a modulo size. Okay. So floor of table size into key into a modulo size. Donald Knuth suggested to use this constant a value as 0.618033. Let here the size of the hash table is 10, so that we can totally store 10 records from 0 to 9. Let here the key value is 23. Let the record is 23. So what is the formula now? H of 23 is equal to floor of, what is the table size? 10 is the table size, 10 into what is key value? 23 into what is a 0.618033 modulo 10, floor of 10 into 23 into 0.618033 is nothing but 142.14 modulo 10. We know that floor will gives the lesser integer value, so 142.4. So what is the lesser integer value? 142. So 142 modulo 10 means 2. So here the key 23 will be stored at the index location 2. So this is about the last approach, that is nothing but multiplicative method. So we have four types of hash functions: division method, and the second method is mid square method, third one is digit folding method, fourth one is multiplicative method. What is division method? H of key is equal to key modulo 10. So by performing just h of key is equal to key modulo size, so by performing modulo with size, we can get the corresponding key value. Whereas mid square method means square the key value, the middle part will becomes the key that is to be stored. Okay, so the corresponding record will be stored at that key. And the next approach is digit folding method. So digit folding method means we have to divide the given key or record into several parts. By performing some simple mathematical operations, we can get the corresponding key value. And the last one is multiplicative method. In multiplicative method, we have to use a formula called floor of table size into key into a modulo size, where the value of constant a is 0.618033. And now let's see the characteristics of a good hash function. Here totally we have 5 characteristics. Let's see the first one. The hash function should be simple to compute. So we have to use a simple hash function for computing the hash key. Next, second characteristics, number of collisions should be less while placing the key in the hash table. So the number of collisions should be less. If there are more number of collisions, then the performance of the hash table will be reduces. Okay. Next property, the cost of computing a hash function should be less. So the cost should be less. Next characteristics, hash function should produce hash key which will be distributed uniformly across the hash table. So we know that hash function produces some hash key, that information will be distributed uniformly across the hash table. Let's see the last characteristic. Hash function should make use of all the information provided by the hash key. So the corresponding hash function should make use of all the information which is provided by the key. So these are the various important characteristics of a hash function.